DBT stands for Design, Build, Test. It's a group-based project whereby students design, manufacture, and test a composite structure. The task this year is to develop an undercarriage beam, which is capable of resisting both a compressive load and a bending load. This bending load is approximately the same as a car being placed on top of the structure.
The structure needs to meet stiffness requirement at limit load, strength and stability requirement at ultimate load. In this exercise, we'll also develop capabilities to predict structural response, failure location, and also failure process of the composite beam.
We have carried out initial material testing to verify the basic material properties given by the manufacturer. We are going to use these material properties to support our design as well as the predicted FE models and further refine them if needed.
So after we did our analytical design, we proceeded to create our final element model you can see here. And the main objective is to first validate our analytical results and second, find the weakest areas in our design so we can reinforce them.
If you imagine this is the beam will be under compression and it will also be under bending. So what you see is in the center of the beam is the most critical region. So we want a lot of plies there for a high strength. But at the outside of the beam, we don't need so many plies to save weight. And therefore we need ply drops along the length of the beam.
Results show that failure will start in the top flange due to instabilities. These are caused by large deformations. And we designed it this way so we could avoid catastrophic failure at the pins, since these two regions are two of the most critical areas.
Once we have our model from Abacus, we can go into the CATIA where we can recreate our geometry and we can have CATIA show us what the plies will actually look like. Once the plies have been generated, we can have CATIA unfold them so that we can use those for the ply cutter.
So basically our design had a problem with excessive rotation. So what we did was create new fittings for the existing fixtures that doesn't allow our beam to tilt like that, and it's only going to allow it to rotate.
We're Team Maverick and we're just laying up a practice beam. And to help with the draping of the plies, we're using a heat gun to help soften the polymer and a dibber tool to help at the corners and to minimize wrinkling.
Since all the plies has been laid up, now our first aim would be basically laying up the release film, which prevents it from sticking to the rest of the materials. Then we lay up breather, which is utilized to spread the pressure uniformly. And then we utilize a sealant tape to ensure that it is tightly sealed. Once that is done, we put it inside the autoclave to cure.
The test setup included several instruments. Firstly, we have used normal and high-speed cameras in order to capture the failure of the beam. Besides that, we have used strain gauges on the beam in order to monitor the load transfer, distribution, and stress gradient, especially in non-critical areas. Furthermore, we have used potentiometers to measure the maximum deflection as well.
So this is a sensor that measures rotational angles. It basically senses gravity's direction. And I'm using a pre-made code. It kind of averages the two measurements to get a kind of a steady but still responsive value.
So we fixed our beam to the test rig using three pins, two at either end and one in the middle. Because the beam bends under loading, we need to use another sensor to measure the deflection.
Ready? Okay, station one is ready. Yeah. Now we're going to be flying 5 kN axle. 2 kN. 13.5 kN. Oh!
It's a good kickoff for your PhD project.
The DBT, and to a wider extent, of course, all the other work we've done so far in Access has been a very unique opportunity. It gives you a much stronger base when you enter your PhD.
When you go in the lab and you do something.
Yeah. Given that all of them are from different backgrounds, you learn from the others as well, like which you would not have learned from doing the project alone. Or you.
I think it's a unique opportunity to work as a team.
To learn about project management.
Communicating.
So I think the DBT gave you the chance to become a more well-rounded individual as you see the process through all the different stages.
We all feel a lot more prepared for the future as engineers.